Evening peeps, good evening everyone. How's everyone doing? Hopefully you're all doing very, very well. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button. If you guys are new to the channel, don't forget as well to like and share the vids. I'm off to Barcelona tomorrow for the Matchroom DAZN fight card out there. I'm presenting the show. Looking forward to it. Sandor Martin headlines against Jose Felix. You guys will remember Sandor Martin for probably one of the biggest upsets. I don't think it was the biggest upset. I think the biggest upset last year was probably Kiko Martinez, Kid Galahad, probably. But Sandor Martin obviously beat Mikey Garcia, which was a huge upset, huge. So he takes on Jose Felix tomorrow. And I guess for him, it's not a ticking over fight. I don't want to be disrespectful to Jose Felix, but it's a fight that Sandor Martin just has to win. You just got to win, and then you put yourself in a position to maybe fight for the vacant world titles. Obviously, Josh Taylor will vacate. He said he will. Sandor Martin's number 4 in the WBA, number 5 in the WBC, so he's not far off fighting for a world title sometime this year, but he's got to get past Jose Felix to do it. So yeah, a fly out tomorrow. Show's on Friday. Looking forward to doing my first... Would it be my first international show for DAZN? I think it will be. I am also doing the Katie Taylor Amanda Serrano fight card that's just been confirmed. And I'm also playing a part in the Canelo Bivol fight card as well. So look, this is crazy. I can't lie to you. This is all a bit crazy. I found all this out a couple of days ago. And I don't know what to tell you. But yeah, that's what's going on in the next, 3 or 4 weeks. So yeah, looking forward to potentially interviewing Canelo. Me. Anyway, let's get out there first before we get carried away with things. All right, let's have a look at what news is trending today. What have we got here? Shakur Stevenson, I'm going to show the world why Oscar Valdez ducked me all this time. Look, it's going to be a good fight, by the way. Shakur is favourite, and I think I've said this a few times. Shakur Stevenson's favourite to win, but, I mean, Oscar Valdez is good. Oscar Valdez is a good, good boxer. A lot stronger than he was before as well, physically. Gets hit too much for me. Always, you know, he's so vulnerable. Especially when he throws heels. Like, when he lets his hands go, it's just like his head's just there to get tagged. Go back and watch. He's made way improvements in this, but go back and watch the Scott Quigg Oscar Valdez fight for reference. But obviously that was a long time ago. He's with a new trainer in Eddie Reynoso. He's a lot better, don't get me wrong. But I'm just trying to say that he has still got that trait for me where, again, when he throws his punches, his head's just up there to be tagged. And I do think Shakur Stevenson will tag it a few times, but it's a good fight. Shakur Stevenson is a favorite, but not a wide favorite, maybe like a 60-40 if we're going to do it in split terms. But yeah, really looking forward to it. Cade Plant desires Canelo rematch, willing to face Benavidez and Charlo first. As Canelo said, these guys should all fight each other, which still isn't happening. And then not only are you then deserving maybe of the Canelo fight, and it's got to that stage where you have to, I think, work for the Canelo fight right now. But not only are you deserving, but I think fans will flock to it more, thinking that you've got a chance. For example, if Charlo were to face Benavidez and beat him, then fucking beat Cade Plant, people are like, okay, all right, you know what, Charlo's got a chance. But now, you don't really give them much of a chance, do you? Just because, again, we're not seeing them go at each other to determine who is the number one to then take on Canelo. It's just facts, isn't it? So I don't know, man. I want to see them all mix it with each other first, and then we'll see. This is crazy, this story. Ben Shalom, Carl must prove he's not finished before taking Brook rematch. So what they're trying to say is that Carl will have a fight and then fight Brook. Carl's done. And look, I'm not one of those people that say it ruins your legacy when you go on and on and on, because for me, Roy Jones Jr. is one of the best fighters ever. And I stopped with Roy when he beat John Ruiz. That's it for me. Him coming down to fight Antonio Tarver was crazy. All the defeats that Roy had after, not that they don't count, but they don't affect Roy's legacy, not for me. And I don't want to say Khan's affecting his legacy by continuing, what Khan's affecting is his health. Like, Khan just hasn't got it no more. And it's no, there's no shame on that. Khan's been fighting as a pro since he was, what, 17, 18? It's a long time. It's a long career. He's been inactive now for the best part of 5-6 years, Khan. Really, look at his resume. He's been fighting once a year, maximum twice a year for a long time. So, yeah, I just want Khan to stop, personally. I think Khan should just hang up the gloves. Even Brook, look, I'm not stupid. As much as Brook thinks he's back, Brook beat that Khan. That Khan was done. So even Brook, I get it. If you, you know, you get that win and there's more money on the table, I can get why Brook wants to have one more. But even Brook should be done after that one more. And I want that one more to be Conor Benn. Obviously, Conor Benn's got Van Heerden on the 16th of April, but providing Conor Benn gets through it, and he should get through it, I'd like to see a summer clash between those two. I think it's a good crossroads fight. I think it makes sense weight-wise. I think Conor Benn will happily go to 150, 151 maybe, and I think that just suits Cale Brook as well. So I think it's a good fight. It's a good fight. It's a big fight. Big fight for us over here anyway. So, look, we'll see. A big fight that has now, well, it's not been officially confirmed, I don't think, yet, but everyone that knows, right, that George Kambosos will now defend all these titles against the WBC lightweight champion Devin Haney in Australia. It was due to be Vasily Lomachenko. That was the first choice. That looked like it was going to happen. Obviously, Vasily Lomachenko has decided to stay in Ukraine. That must have been a tough decision. And I say that just because, you know, at his age, and we all know now what's going on with the rematch clauses putting into these contracts, at his age, and with a rematch clause possibly into the contract, no, not possibly in the contract, he's not going to get the opportunity now for, oh, the way boxing works now, 18 months? 18 months, and it's too, as much as I love Loma, he'll be done at the very elite level in 2 years, wouldn't he? I mean, I think Loma's incredible, but his body's already fallen apart. So in 18 months to 2 years, he's done. So it must have been a tough decision to say, no, regardless of that, regardless of the money on the table, I'm staying in Ukraine. Because you look at someone like Usyk. Usyk's obviously taken the AJ fight. He wants it. You know, he's gone to Poland. He's getting ready for Anthony Joshua. So anyway, look, it will be Devin Haney versus George Kambosos. Devin Haney is going to Australia. People... I'd be like, oh, Devin Haney's so brave going to Australia. It's a 20-hour flight. Man, he's not like he's doing it voluntarily. He's going to get paid well. He's going to get paid well, and he has a chance to become undisputed. I mean, this is what George Kambosos has bloody been doing. George Kambosos lives in Australia. He's been traveling all over to get these opportunities. He's been doing the 24-hour travels to fight these people. All of a sudden, an American does the opposite thing. Everyone's like, oh, man, he's really, you know, going above and beyond. He's not going above and beyond. It's just how it is. Look, one of these guys is going to walk away undisputed, which is crazy. And what I don't like, and it's not a dig at Kambosos because everyone seems to do it, is these bloody rematch clauses and, you know, fighters having to tie themselves down. It's just nonsense, isn't it? Like, all I want to see is one fight between Kambosos and Haney. One fight. If it's a great fight, then do it again. And again, it's not just Kambosos, I'm having a dig. AJ does this. All these rematch clauses, I can't stand them because it just holds up the division. It really does. Like, in an ideal world, if one person wins convincingly, then move on to the next. If Kambosos loses to Haney, I don't know, a knockout, why should they do it again? Why should they? It should be, okay, next man up. That next man up could be Ryan Garcia. That next man up could be Javonte Davis. That next man up could be Vasily Lomachenko. I hate the idea of rematch clauses in fights. Again, we, the public, will determine whether or not we want to see it again. That's how it works. We determine, not these promoters putting it in the contracts. It's just, it's annoying. It's been a while since I've had a little drink while filming. A bit of Jack Daniels needed. It's been a long day, peeps. It's been a long, long day. But look, I'm excited for the fight. It should be a good fight. I think if you're Kambosos, I think you've kind of dodged a bullet here, because I think Lomachenko would have beat him, and I think he would have embarrassed him a little bit, if I'm honest with you. I think Lomachenko is that good. and styles make fights. Whereas I think this is actually a 50-50 scrap. I really do think it is a 50-50 fight. But look, good luck to whoever gets it. DAZN must be livid. Obviously, they've been working with Devin Haney now for, I think, about five fights. And they're not involved in this. They're not involved at all. And so they're not going to be happy. And even in the rematch, they're not involved in that either. Even if Devin Haney wins, crazy. Eddie must be livid. You've put that much stock into a fighter. He, you know, a lot of people think he'll win this. He's favourite to become undisputed, and you're not there. DAZN aren't there for that. Crazy. Absolutely crazy. Terence Crawford. I give Spence the edge, but Ugas has what it takes to derail him. Certainly does. Quick one on Terence Crawford. It's come out now that he will sign a two-fight deal with PBC. Good luck to him. Hopefully he makes some good money. And hopefully he can... I mean, hopefully, you know, within that contract, it's a case of, okay, he gets the winner of Ugas Spence and potentially maybe even a Keith Thurman's on that contract. He needs to make sure it's all written down correctly what he's getting. Not that he's just signing a deal and then will be kept on the shelf, because we know that PBC can sometimes keep people on the shelf. What else we got? Saw this fight here, very weird. Munguia versus Jacobs. Looks like they're going to do a catchweight fight on DAZN. Now look, Munguia is coming off a couple of good wins. But Jacobs is coming off a loss to John Ryder. I mean, Jacobs, I like Jacobs. I do. I like Danny Jacobs a lot. But and look, some people might even say he won that fight against John Ryder, and maybe so. But he's not that guy anymore. I mean, Munguia really needs to be going for the bigger names. He really does. I mean, Danny Jacobs just... And you're asking Danny Jacobs to boil himself down as well. I don't know, man. I don't know. What else have we got here, peeps? Ryan Garcia on critics. It drives me to work hard. I don't want to prove those guys right. Let's just see what he can do, man. Obviously, he's got this Emmanuel Tego. And it has been a while since we've seen Ryan Garcia in the ring. Let's see. I think the Issac Cruz fight would have been a lot better, and we would have been able to answer a lot of questions that have been thrown at Ryan Garcia. But again, for a fighter like him, who I'm excited to see return, I just want it to be a case of you get the win and we move on and we can start to see some things happen in this lightweight division. A lot of talking from Ryan Garcia in the last couple of years, not much delivering apart from that Luke Campbell win, which was obviously a very, very good win. Anything else? Let's have a look, people. Okay, this is interesting. A bit more on Kell Brook. He said Amir Khan must be crazy for wanting a rematch. And he said his representatives have reached out to Danny Garcia. It's a fight that I really wanted to see 6-7 years ago. Now, I don't know. Danny's still very, very sharp. Like, Danny's last fight was Errol, right? Was it Errol Spence? Let's have a look. I think it was. Errol fought him after that crash, right? But I thought Danny looked actually quite sharp in that fight. Errol was just too big, too strong. Yeah, it was on the what date was it? The 5th of December 2020. So it's been a while since we've seen Danny Garcia in the ring. I don't mind it. Danny Garcia has been speaking about wanting to go to 154. Obviously, Kell's fought at 154. Kell's fought at 160. So there's something in that. I like it. Again, I mean, for Sky, they would love it. Would Danny travel to the UK? Does he have any want to travel to the UK? I mean, I guess money's on the table, and he'll look at Kell and think Kell's not a big 154 at all. So I like it. I like it. All right, let's have a quick look and see if Mike Coppinger has anything. Okay, a bit here about Inoue and Nonito Donaire, their rematch. It's been a while, that one. I mean, it should have happened ages ago. Remember, it was 2019 Fight of the Year. They're now doing it in 2022. I mean, Donaire's, don't get me wrong, Donaire's obviously having an Indian summer, but I'm not quite sure. They're going to meet June 7th in Japan. Seems like there's a lot of things going on in and around that date. We're hearing that, obviously, Kambosos versus Haney's in and around that date. Now we got this one. There's a lot of talk as well about AJ Usyk being in and around that date. So we're already starting to get a lot happening for May and June, which is very, very good. All right, guys, I think that is that. Everyone have a good day. Loads of videos coming, as I said. We're going to do a Gennady Golovkin video. In fact, I'm going to film that right now, and that'll probably go up tomorrow as well.